I'm Dr. Alvin Malesky, and this is a short video detailing the psychology of hate travel experience. Now, the reason I refer to it as a travel experience is because there are really two components. There is a online, approximately about 4-week online course that really covers the academics for the trip itself and also sets the stage and helps prepare students for international travel. And then there's a travel component itself. Now, these are broken up into, they can be broken up into three credit courses. The online course, you can get 3 hours of upper level psychology credit for that. And you can also get 3 hours of upper level psychology credit for the travel course. You don't have to do them both. You could choose to do one or the other. However, I would strongly encourage you to sign up for both the online course and the travel course if at all possible. As far as the online course goes, there's several objectives. Like I said, it really sets the academic stage, the foundation for the things that we will be seeing firsthand in the travel component. We'll talk about a lot of the social psychology research that at least attempts to explain how seemingly normal people could do some pretty horrific things. We will look at suggestions on how people could perhaps stop some of these atrocities from occurring in the future. And we'll also see why those suggestions have not always been successful, as unfortunately it's evidenced by genocide since World War II. And finally, we'll spend a little time talking about King Ludwig. King Ludwig led a very interesting life and kind of an interesting death, or at least there's a mystery surrounding his final hours, and we'll kind of go into that. He was declared incompetent to be king. He was a king of Bavaria at the time. We'll go into to his history, his background, and the factors that led to his death as part of the course as well. The way the course is going to be structured, the online course is going to be structured, is each week we'll have a different topic, and I'm going to be posting articles to read, actual academic studies, but also chapters from books that focus on conformity and obedience. We'll be taking chapters from The Lucifer Effect by Phil Zimbardo and talking about that in our online discussions. We'll be taking chapters from The Psychology of Hate and also discussing those. We'll watch Zimbardo's classic prison study and see how, again, you know, the issues of conformity and obedience, people assuming certain roles could lead to people acting in certain ways in certain circumstances that they might normally not have acted that specific way in. We'll watch actual Nazi propaganda films and kind of go into some of the psychology that might at least somewhat explain the rise of the Third Reich. Now, as far as the grades are concerned, each week, and like I said, it's right now looking at like 4 weeks, we'll have a specific topic, and I'm going to post a specific discussion question to the class at the beginning of the week. Usually it has something to do with a video that I'll post or a journal article, and students have to actively participate on the discussion board. That means multiple posts and multiple responses to posts over the course of the week. This is also going to serve as a trip preparation. The online course will serve as a trip preparation. So each week we'll be taking a specific city that we're going to be visiting, and the students are going to actually research thoroughly that city. I'm talking about the level of looking at the subway plans, the layout of the city itself. And I ask the students to identify a specific site that's not on our official itinerary. And last time I did this trip, we actually go to the sites that the students identified on their own kind of prep research. So I think that kind of gives the students a little bit more say in what they want to do and can do. And it basically invests them in the process a little bit more on these trips. So we'll try to do that, or that will be a component of the online course. It kind of helps bring to life what we're about to do, and at the same time decrease, I believe, some of the anxieties that's associated with international travel. 2 years ago, most of the students who went with me had never been out of the country before. And there was, I think, a certain level of anxiety. That's to be expected with that trip itself. So I'm going to try to do this trip preparation kind of to help decrease the anxiety, but also get as much out of the travel component of the experience as possible. And finally, there's a summary paper that's associated with the online class. Now, as far as the travel classes go, so the dates right now are looking like June 9th through June 21st, although it's not 100% set in stone, but that's what we're looking at right now. Last time I went 2 years ago, it was focused almost entirely on the Holocaust, the trip itself was. So we flew into Germany, spent some time in Poland, and then spent some time into Prague. Based on feedback from the students, we'll be focusing on the Holocaust, but not exclusively on the Holocaust on this trip. We'll be flying into Munich, Germany. We'll spend some time in Venice, Italy, go over to Switzerland for a couple of days, and end up in Heidelberg. Now, that, what I just mentioned, that section of this trip will be with EF Tours. It's an educational tour company that specializes in these type trips for university students and for high school students. And I'll tell you a little bit more about them here in a second. The thing, based on feedback from students 2 years ago, that we're going to do a little bit different than that's indicated on the map on your screen is that EF Tours has a stay behind, and they take people to, if they're interested in, pay a little bit more to Paris. But based on the feedback that we received 2 years ago, we're going to do our own stay behind. We'll probably end up staying behind in Frankfurt, Germany, and for 3 extra days. And we'll go to Heidelberg. We'll try to go to Nuremberg, and we'll try to go to Berlin. Take basically 3 day trips. And that's just going to be the Western students. It's just going to be us, and it's going to be without EF support. But by that time, students usually feel comfortable enough to do travel. I know Germany, and a student who, our former graduate student of mine, speaks fluent German. He went on the trip 2 years ago. He's working on his doctorate right now at another institution, and he's going to be taking the trip with us too. And so I'm confident that we'll be able to negotiate and navigate through Germany. But the students really liked it because the last 3 days really gave them a lot more autonomy, and we weren't tied into the, pretty regimented itinerary of the tour company. So in essence, I think we ended up with the best of both worlds, and I think we will this time too. We have a very specific focus, a good educationally focused itinerary with EF Tours for the first, the majority, two-thirds of the trip, and then the final quarter to a third of the trip, we have a lot more autonomy, and we'll be able to do and kind of go off and go exploring a little bit more on our own at that point. We will end up though, or I'm sorry, we'll start off in Munich, Germany. This is the city center in Munich, Germany. This is the birthplace of the Third Reich, and we'll be experiencing that going all in. We'll do a tour, Third Reich tour, and that really focuses on the rise of the Third Reich. One of the places on this tour is this particular beer hall. It's called the Hofstra House. Interesting story. Right after World War I, a corporal, I guess a formal corporal, went and was assigned to be a spy in the beer hall. This corporal turned out to be Adolf Hitler. And after listening to speeches as a spy for about 2 months, Hitler eventually took the stage himself and started to galvanize the crowd. While we're in Munich, we'll also go to Dachau. It's a concentration camp, was a concentration camp outside of Munich. These are 3 students who went on the trip 2 years ago, and it's a pretty powerful experience. Like I said, on our stay behind, I want to go down to Nuremberg. It was part of our trip the last time we went, but this time it's going to be a part of the add-on part. But one of the reasons I think it's a good thing to do is just because we start the trip in Munich, the birthplace of the Third Reich, and to end it in Nuremberg is, I think, a pretty, it kind of brings everything full circle. This is the actual courtroom where the war crimes trial took place, and this is the class that actually went 2 years ago. As I said, we'll also visit Neuschwanstein. This is the Disney castle. It was a castle that King Ludwig commissioned, an absolutely gorgeous, just phenomenally gorgeous area. These are some of the students who went again 2 years ago, and that's one of the side trips that I would like us to do, or that we will do when we're in Munich. Now, as far as the specifics of the course, it's going to be 13 days. The first 10 days will be with EF Tours. The final 3 days will be on our own. Like I said, EF Tours is a tour company that specializes on these type trips for college students or university students and even high school students. As far as the price is concerned, we're looking roughly around $4,000, and that should cover the cost of travel. That should cover the hotel for our entire stay. That should cover all transportation going from city to city to city, our rail pass. It should cover airlines tickets, and it should cover most of our food as well. For students who are interested in getting the 3 credit hours of travel, or the 3 hours for the travel course, that would be an additional $500 to pay to the Western Carolina University to get those 3 hours for that. Now, if you want to qualify for financial aid, you would have to take 6 hours, and that's why we have the online course as well. So if you take that class and then sign up for the travel course, the $500 for the $450 to $500 for the travel course credit, that would be 6 hours of upper level psychology credit and would qualify you for financial aid. Now, the financial aid package that you, if you're eligible for, will cover the entire trip itself, which will cover everything here. That's how most of the students, not all, but that's how most of the students paid for the trip 2 years ago when we went. If you decide to pay on your own, EF Tours has a payment plans that you could set up to kind of help defer the cost, or at least spread the cost out over time. If you're interested, I would recommend that you consider checking out our group on Facebook, but definitely talk with your family, talk with your parents, talk with your friends. Look at the itinerary. I've posted the itinerary off my website, the EF Tours specific itinerary, and you'll see it's pretty intense, packed with a lot of cool things to do. I've also posted the 2 syllabi, the syllabi for the online component and the syllabi for the travel component as well. So I would recommend you talk with family about this is going to be something you could do. I would also recommend that you check with our financial aid office to see if you would qualify for financial aid. And I would do that sooner than later. Most importantly, however, I would suggest that you talk with me about the trip. Hopefully I'll be able to answer all your questions, and we can go on and start, you know, looking at making this happen. There's a lot of WCU paperwork associated with this, not surprisingly, so we will need to get that filled out. And then finally, the last thing, once we have our critical group, which we need at least 6 students, we had 8 students who went last time, but once we have our minimum critical mass of 6 students, we'll go on and register with EF Tours. These are just some pictures on the page of students who went 2 years ago. I said the Brandenburg Gates in Berlin. Students down here at the corner they decided they wanted to go to the Graffiti Museum in Berlin. That's one of the things that they had identified. I had never heard about it, but when they were researching the city of Berlin, multiple students said, yeah, I want to check that out. So sure enough, our first day there, we had some free time. We decided to hop on the train, and off our group went. We were trekking around Berlin, but we found the Graffiti Museum, which is what the students wanted to see. So we were actually able to go and spend some time doing that. And the other picture down here, I believe that's the class, or most of the class, in Krakow, night out in Krakow. Now, with EF Tours, we'll be going with other groups from other universities, but we'll have a full-time tour guide with us, a full-time bus. Again, they'll take care of all the transportation as we traipse across Europe. The final 3 days, however, is just going to be us, and we're going to be able to do things on our own at that point. Again, it's somewhat intimidating at the beginning for students who have never traveled before, but what happened last time we went is by our final part of the course, students were feeling extremely comfortable traveling and doing things that they would never have thought they would have felt comfortable doing prior to departing the United States. I hope you're interested in this course, and if you have any questions, please contact me, and I will hopefully be able to answer them, and we could be moving forward with this. Thank you.